Hi, my name is Nobuyuki Akagi. I am a Japanese patent attorney working for Fukami Patent Office. My majors are chemistry and material science. Today, I want to talk about the patent prosecution strategy using PCT-PPH in Japan. Here we go! I recommend using PCT-PPH to obtain patent right in Japan for the three reasons. The first reason is fast examination. The second reason is reduction of costs. The third reason is a high allowance rate. I will explain the details later. Firstly, I would like to explain the basic system of the PCT-PPH in Japan. First, an applicant files a PCT application in a first filing office. Next, the applicant will receive ISA or may optionally receive IPER at the international stage. After that, the PCT application enters Japan at the national stage. If the ISA or IPR have the good results regarding patentability, the applicant can file a request for the PCT-PPH in Japan. The JPO will do accelerated examination for the Japanese application. I will explain the major requirements for the PCT-PPH in Japan. The major requirements have the 3 points. The first point is that at least one claim of the PCT application is determined to be allowable in the ISA or IPER. The second point is that all the claims in Japan sufficiently correspond to those claims determined to be patentable in the ISA or IPER. The third point is that the examination of the Japanese application which the PCT-PPH is requested for has not begun. The important thing in this slide is official fees free, but the attorney's fee will be incurred because the Japanese patent attorney will have to make some document for a request for the PCT-PPH in Japan. To obtain patent right in Japan, I recommend using PCT-PPH. Why? The first reason is fast examination. Look at this slide. This slide shows average period from filing a request for examination or PPH till receiving first action from the JPO. This data is from 2020 July to December from the JPO. As shown in this slide, the average period of all the patent applications from filing a request for examination till receiving first action from the JPO is about 10 months. The average period of the normal PPH from filing a request for PPH to receiving first action from the JPO is about 3 months. In contrast, if you file a request for the PCT-PPH in Japan, you can receive first action from the JPO by 2.5 months after the filing of the PCT-PPH. This average period is much shorter than that of all the patent applications and shorter than that of normal PPH. Therefore, the PCT-PPH can achieve the fast examination. The second reason is reduction of costs. This slide shows fast action patent allowance rate in Japan. The fast action patent allowance rate means that the fast action is a notice of allowance. As shown in this slide, first action patent allowance rate of all the patent applications is about 14%. The first action patent allowance rate of the normal PPH is about 23%. However, if you file a request for PCT-PPH in Japan, you can receive notice of allowance at the first action at the rate of 55%. This allowance rate of the PCT-PPH is much higher than those of all the patent applications and normal PPH. This data means reduction of costs by filing a request for the PCT-PPH in Japan because we do not receive unnecessary obstructions. The final reason is high allowance rate. This slide shows the total patent allowance rate in Japan. As shown in this slide, the total patent allowance rate of all the patent applications is about 74%. The total patent allowance rate of the normal PPH is about 80%. However, if you file a request for the PCT-PPH in Japan, you can receive a notice of allowance at the rate of 94%. Therefore, the total patent allowance rate of the PCT-PPH is much higher than those of all the patent applications and the normal PPH. In conclusion, I recommend using PCT-PPH to obtain patent right in Japan for the three reasons. The first reason is fast examination. The second reason is reduction of costs. The third reason is high allowance rate. Thank you for listening to my presentation. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us. The email address is here. Thanks.